The SCP faction is still here in Totally Accurate Battle Simulator, and we are not nearly done checking out all of these terrifying, horrifying units. This is SCP-1048, Builder Bear. Take a look at this tiny little teddy bear. I wonder what's so terrifying about him. He seems kind of cute to me. What do you think? Comment down below. Is he adorable or is he scary? Look at the eyes hiding in there. You see that? There's his terrifying looking eyes hiding inside the Build-A-Bear. Let's see what he can do versus equal point value squires. 500 points versus 500 points. Little Build-A-Bear, little SCP-1048 going in to fight the squires. No, the squires just executed the bear. That's terrifying. This unit is SCP-1005, the Painted Man. What did he do to become an SCP? You can see his body is covered in paint, and he has the painter's weapons at his disposal, and he's about to fight some hoplites and some ceresis. The Painted Man moves in, his hands behind his back. Beautiful painter's dodge. Going to town, trying to paint his enemies with the paintbrush. One hoplite is down. He's still alive, fighting beautifully all of these units. I love his outfit. I love how he looks like he's just wearing a white suit, but the white suit is covered in all sorts of blue paints. Paints fitting with what's on his painter's, what is that called? The painter's paint collecting pad thing? There's an official name for that device, that object. I don't know what it is. Ooh, there's a whole bunch of dead ceresis and hoplites. Most of the hoplites are dead. There are three ceresis still alive. The painter continues to go. Come on, painter, you can do it. I have faith in SCP-1008. He can pull this off. Going to town toe-to-toe with one hoplite. No! The hoplites and the ceresis were too powerful for our SCP unit. This is SCP-3008-2. The Infinite IKEA. Is it like some IKEA worker gone horribly, horribly wrong? He just looks like a dude wearing some clothes. Like, yeah, welcome to IKEA. Try the Spanish meatballs. He's gonna fight a bunch of halflings, a bunch of halflings. He's worth 3,000 points. Maybe he can do some crazy things. The Infinite IKEA. Some fear going on. Big ground smash sent hobbits flying. The Infinite IKEA is not ready to deal with your baloney. He doesn't care. If you don't eat the meatballs in the cafeteria at IKEA, he will punish you just like that. This one is called SCP-323-1, the Wendigo Skull. If you saw this thing in the darkness, just kind of looking at you with those terrifying beady eyes, I'd leave the room. I'd run the other way. I'd go find help because he's terrifying looking. And he's going to fight a whole boatload of monks. The Wendigo Skull with the shout. Apparently, I chose the right map for this. He's going to shove those people off the map. He's eating the monk. What did that monk ever do to you, Wendigo Skull? My God, he ate the monk to death. Swallowed all of its life energy. Oh my God, he's devouring the monks. Problem is, there's water there. And I highly doubt the Wendigo Skull can swim. He tried to eat the monk, even in the ocean. Terrifying. This one is called SCP-2191-1, Dracula Factory. Dracula Factory seems like a weird name. How does one manufacture a bunch of Draculas? There it is. Did a quick little jump. It's facing some skeletons, which may be a bad idea. Because hey, Dracula Factory, you okay? Oh, he was just playing dead, letting his enemies get close so he can get to work with his knife. And he keeps flopping around. He's eating people. So that's the Dracula part. Problem is, they're skeletons. Mr. Dracula Factory, you're not going to get a whole lot of blood out of skeletons, like squeezing blood out of a stone. I forgot to inform you, there is none, as Dracula Factory continues to work on these skeletons, getting them down one by one. Do the skeletons have enough damage to defeat the Dracula Factory? Or will our Dracula Factory SCP unit reign supreme and defeat the remainder of these skeleton archers? Three archers left, one Dracula Factory trying to eat the skeletons, getting upset that he can't get any sustenance from them because they're just bones. They're not even skin of bones. They're just bones. One archer, one Dracula. I wonder how much HP he had left after all that. This one's called SCP-811, the swamp woman. Clearly, a lovely lady fell into the swamp and then maybe died. Maybe was converted into the swamp lady by the swamp. Maybe she was born there. I have questions. And the swamp lady is going to fight the Renaissance faction. This Renaissance person is shocked to see the swamp lady. Maybe this is this man's wife. And he's like, honey, what are you doing here? The swamp lady continues to attack. Yo, throws the reaper, throw a big explosion of probably swamp guck and bleh, or dark energy of sorts. Now she's eating. This halberd user, as the halberds rain down on her, seemingly unaffecting the swamp woman. She shakes off the halberd attacks and continues to nom 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 on these lovely halberd units, even doing as much as scaring the halberd unit away. Om nom nom. Look at her just devouring this halberd unit. Just disgusting. That's just disgusting. The final halberd unit exploded. An explosion of dark energy coming out of the swamp woman. My goodness. This one is called SCP-939 With Many Voices. I wonder what the With Many Voices SCP can do to these lovely squires. It seems to be a dinosaur or lizard of sorts. Took a whole bunch of arrows to the stomach and didn't even care. Are you gonna eat this guy? What is with SCPs and eating people? Is that an SCP thing? Is that a common occurrence amongst the SCP kind? Because every time I play with one of these, all they want to do is eat and eat and eat and devour. And hearing the slurping in my ears is just terrifying. Not having a good time. Eating all these squires, the archers trying to fight, being scared away. I do understand. I do get the fear. The fear effect makes a bunch of sense to me because these SCP are terrifying. They're horror visages. But the om nom nom, maybe the other things than om nom nom. Our SCP unit only has a couple of archers left as he continues his nom 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 himself, finishing off this fight. This one is called SCP-353, The Vector. I wonder what she can do. She's gonna do some wibbly wobbly magic stuff here with her hands against these poor little brawlers. Hold on. Did she throw potions? What is she shooting? Hello? Okay, big giant fear. This one's actually pretty strong. What is that? What came out of your hands? The gas. There's a gas cloud. So one of them is like the potion from Larry, but the other one is this purple gas cloud. I really like this unit. This one's very unique and cool. This one is called SCP-990. The Dream Man. And you know, just looking at him, yeah, I wouldn't go to sleep either. I would avoid sleeping. I would stay awake for as long as possible, because you know, Freddy Krueger style, this guy is gonna jump in your dreams and be all like, hey, do not expect the barrage. The barrage is something I did not think about. Cactus units against the Dream Man. The poor guy, his stomach and back have been skewered multiple times by the cactus units. Another barrage impacted the cactus units. There are two dead. But this Dream Man is suddenly being hugged to death by spiky spikeness, and it's probably not a good time. Another one is dead. His knife is going to work. His knife went to work, skewering all these cactus people. This one is called SCP-1678-A, The Un-London. To be un-London, is that like the anti-London? He seems to be a British soldier, and he's gonna fight some berserkers. He's got a beautiful shotgun, and now, oh, the fear. The fear is crowd controlling some of these berserkers, but the berserkers are leaping in on him, preventing him from doing his job and taking efficient shots with that blunderbuss. Having a hard time. There is one berserker dead with his butt in the air, poor berserker. Another berserker has died. The blunderbuss is finally starting to work. The fear effect isn't really affecting the berserkers too much. They continue to leap on this poor, I think I'm saying poor SCP. Like, oh no, the SCP needs help. No, the SCP is perfectly fine. And he's actually shotgunning these berserkers to death. This un-London SCP unit. I wonder what the dash A means. What does a dash letter or number mean to an SCP? Does that mean that there's a base unit to the SCP and then there's a modified version? Maybe something has happened to the SCP unit, something to cause it to just transform or become a different version of itself? I imagine that's the case, as we're now left to two berserkers who continue to leap over the SCP unit, down to one berserker. Our shotgun user, I just want to check. Shotgun user still has plenty of HP. He's going to finish these poor berserkers as this one. Oh, he's alive. He was alive. I don't know what to do. There was one that was actually alive, just chilling there. This guy here, frozen under the ground. There we go. Shotgun to the face, finishing off this berserker. We are left one berserker who took a shotgun blast to the back. destroying him, leaving our SCP unit to be horizontal to the ground, lying. This one is called SCP-173, the sculpture. And he clearly looks like a statue is about to throw down with the boxing gloves on these poor, unsuspecting farmers. Oh, that right hook just destroyed that farmer. But he's having a hard time. They've been to fear. Again, the SCP fear seems to be a very common thing, which makes a boatload of sense to me. But he's having a hard time actually fighting and punching all of these farmers. He's not really killing them very efficiently. The SCP as a whole are not the most powerful TABS units. I mean, sure, in the real world, facing real humans, you're probably going to do amazing things. But this guy can't even box a farmer. This farmer just keeps running. There might be a universe, a world here where our SCP unit almost went off the edge. Oh, that would have been hilarious. Somehow we're down to 3 farmers. I don't know how. Maybe some of the farmers drowned in the water. This farmer will go off the edge. Just go off the edge. Take the SCP unit with you. Just take the SCP unit with you off the edge. I don't think he's actually punched and killed a single one of these. I think they've all run into the water, run off a cliff. Look, another one into the ocean. Our SCP unit might drown. Oh, he's alive. He's on the steps. He's still there holding it off. Maybe he can finally successfully punch one of these farmers. Sorry. They can't kill farmers. He's on the stairs. Another farmer drowned. Okay, here it is. Here it is, guy. This is your guy. You gotta punch this boxer, punch this farmer to death. You must do it. I believe in you. No, the farmer's gonna go in the hole. No. No. Red Victory defeated the farmers by default. This is SCP-1504. Joe Schmo. What is Joe Schmo? He looks like just a regular old dude wearing some ratty clothing. Maybe he was a gamer. Maybe he would like World of Warcraft, and he just looks like an average guy locked away. But why Joe Schmo versus some vampires? Come on, Joe. Oh, Joe's floating. Joe's getting eaten. Joe. Oh, flat appeal. Joe Schmo. Joe Schmo. Joe Schmo's legit. Wow.